Welcome back to Mastering Maven. Today we're going to be covering the cable cam and orbit features on the digital Copilot. Before we get started, I'm going to check the weather on the Aloft app. It's showing winds at 7 miles an hour with a gust of 12. It feels windier than that. We've got the drone powered up. Let's go ahead and connect. Start the drone recording and tap the three dots. Enable the Copilot. Let's get the drone up in the air. With the Copilot active, I'm going to switch over to map view and tap the map to add a point of interest. Point of interest defaults to a 40-foot elevation. That indicates where the drone is going to be pointing when it's focused on that point of interest. I'm going to raise that up to about 50 feet because my point of interest is a lighthouse. It's a little bit taller. Got the yaw control and the gimbal control turned on. You see it slews around to point at my point of interest. Turning the orbit on as a circle. The radius is my current distance from the point of interest, and I can use the right stick to move that in or out and change that relative position. Moving the right stick left or right allows me to start the orbit and set the speed. It's pretty windy out here today, but the app is still doing a pretty good job of keeping my point of interest in focus as we orbit around. Again, using the right stick, move it up or down will change your orbit radius. The two buttons on the right, you can change the focus of your point of interest. It's currently set to keep it center frame. I can drop it down to lower third. In this case, I think the center frame looks better, so we'll put it back there. Moving the right stick left or right will control the speed of the rotation and the direction. So I'm slowing it down and go the other direction, and now we'll rotate in the opposite direction from what we started. Pressing the stop button will discontinue the orbit, leaves it enabled, but just stops the movement. Now let's switch over to the cable cam feature. We've got this nice row of boats here that'll make a good target for our cable cam feature. Get my drone in the starting position I want, turn on the cable cam, tap the map, and then zoom around and find what destination point I want. See, it drops a line from my drone's current position to the destination I've selected. And now as I'm moving along, the drone will stay on that cable cam line no matter how I slew the drone around. While I was editing this, I had a little bit of a squirrel moment when I noticed the difference between the drone's speed and its set cable cam speed. If you notice, the cable cam is set to go at 33.6 miles per hour, but the drone is actually moving 24 miles an hour. This is a good indication of how a headwind can affect your drone. This can also affect your drone's ability to get back to you if you're bringing it back with a headwind. Coming back now with a tailwind, you can see that the cable cam set speed and the drone speed match. So not going to go faster than you set it with a tailwind, but the headwind can dramatically affect its movement. With the cable cam activated as you approach either end of the line, the drone will slow to a stop. So I get to the end here, I'm holding the stick full down, the drone slows and then comes to a stop at the end of the line. That has been the Maven Copilot Orbit and Cable Cam feature. Both of these features allow you to get some great shots that would be difficult, if not impossible, to get flying manually. Click on this video here to learn how to win a free copy of the Maven app. I'll be giving away 10 copies on the 18th of May, 2022. Thank you for watching. If you've learned something and you feel I've earned it, I'd appreciate a subscription. If you like this content, please give it a thumbs up. It lets me know that you would like to see more of this type of training. Thank you. We'll see you next time.